good afternoon. I hope it's working. It did something weird then, the camera. Yeah, good afternoon, everyone. Welcome back. Yeah, we're at Cowden today, one of my favourite beaches. It's a Monday. You think, come on a Monday, there ain't going to be nobody here. I think everybody's took the day off work. There's a few of us here. So I'm here with Taxi Dave today, down at Cowden. Hoping, fingers crossed, that the rays are going to show. Maybe a bass and the odd stray codling. So I think Dave said his mate was here yesterday. He had a couple of decent codling, about £4, but that means absolutely nothing when I rock up on the beach. And you've seen that time and time again. So our tide's in about 3 hours. I honestly think we're going to get washed off. Taxi Dave reckons we'll be all right, sunny small tide. But we ain't got much of a get up, get down here. So we'll see. It might be a little bit sketchy today. Might have to left, right, left down the beach a little bit. But yeah. So I'm just fishing with one rod at the moment. Yeah, I know, Van, I know. I'm going to fish two once the tide's been up when it's on its way back down again. So yeah, I'm into faff. So yeah. Taxi Dave's in. I'm in. Let's hope the fish are in. I'll see you soon. So yeah, this is the start of my week off work. This is Monday, but whatever it is. I don't know, 28th is it? And as usual, the weather's rubbish for the rest of the week. So I'm planning a trip. Me and Vern were planning a trip. I was gonna go to Vern's house, spend some time with him there, and then over on the Lynx coast, east coast, but the weather looks absolutely dire for the next few days, so I might only get a couple of sessions in this week, but you've got to take the rough with the smooth, haven't you, with this lark. So it is gorgeous though. I mean, I know we all like it sunny. I'd have a tendency to not like it sunny. I prefer it like this, overcast. Absolutely beautiful. Temperatures round about, I'd say 12 to 14, that tide is getting close now. Don't know where I'm gonna go. We took in that alcove with Taxi Dave. But yeah, conditions are perfect. I've always done alright on this beach. First time I've been on it this year. I'm hoping to do a few more sessions on here this year. Especially it gets a bit warmer. I had a few rays off here last summer. Seen a few videos back. But yeah, I want to catch a ray, I want to catch a bass. But while there's still that chance of that decent codling, you know, in me out of arts, I know that's what I would like to pick up today. But we'll see. Anyway, it looks good. Conditions are ace, as I've said. There's plenty of people on the beach fishing, so that's always a good sign. Let's just hope we can pick some up. See you in a bit. Yeah, well, nothing first cast. Thought I was getting a few nibbles, but bait's come back from basically untouched, so I've just stuck a bit of frozen black on there just to top it up, and we'll see how we get on. See you soon. Not had a bite yet, but I'm gonna try. I might try and chain it. I've put a yellow tail on again and tip it with I'll put that lug and yellow tail on, and then after that I'll probably try mackerel or prawn. So yeah, we'll see how we get on in a bit. Welcome back again. Still not happening, apart from we've had a bit of a tactical rethink, because down there I was going to get washed off, and I had no plan B. No plan B. So I've moved back to the get down. So yeah, this is the get down and the get up at Cowden. It's one of the better ones, one of the better get downs on the Holderness coast. So yeah, I'll show you where I came from. Where Dave is next to me, the guy after him, I was about 100 yards away from him. I had to come streaming down the beach once this geezer had moved to get into his patch. Now he's probably moved because it was crap and he's not caught now. So I've probably moved, well, knowing my luck, from a productive area to a non-productive area. But saying that, this is where I fished last year when he had them rays. So I know the coast changes and the beach changes, but yeah, so that's the get down. That's my point of safety. There's the tide. We've got another hour and a bit before our tide. It's supposed to be just a small tide today, 4.9. There's one other guy down there. And that way on is towards Mapleton and then Auntie. So yeah, you've all seen Cowden. Ex-bombing range. I said bombing. There's a chance of finding ordnance. I'm not going to go rooting. I'm not that idiotic. But there you are, yeah. So, yellowtail and frozen black lug on. And then it's going to be, I'm going to change to mackerel, give mackerel a go, see if I can tempt a ray with mackerel, or a dogfish anyway. So, yeah, I'll see you in a bit. Oh, now it works. Screws on. Yeah, so switch over to mackerel now. See if we can get anything. Anything's a bit quiet. No bites as such, not really. And not what you can say, yeah, I'll have a go at that. I'm hoping there's a dogfish about. I don't mind a dogfish. And Dave's not had out, and the guy next to him's not had anything, so. Absolutely perfect for it. Beautiful day. Just no bites yet, which is a bit disappointing. coming up to 2 o'clock. I'm as far back as I can go really before I go. Don't know if I might keep on the beach, might be all right. We might get lucky. Got my new wellies on. Look at these. Bob on them. Feet feel so much better in these. Get in. Yeah. Why is it every time I come fishing, the day before somebody's caught something? I can guarantee you somebody will come tomorrow and they'll catch something. Bit of a Jonah. A little pulley panel rig on. I might change over to a tour clip down. But there again, do I want to be that far out? Do I need to be that far out? There's plenty of colour in close. It's well coloured. We're going to have to rely on the ebb. Is it going to fish on the ebb? We'll see. So yeah, next time you see me, I'll have my new camera. It comes tomorrow, which will be Tuesday the 29th. Tripod comes Wednesday, so I'm hoping because I'm going to Vans on Wednesday. So I don't want to miss that. But yeah, I'm looking forward to the new camera. Hopefully, that ain't crackling too much. You won't see any fairy bits anymore. The fairy muff will be gone. Confident if I got a decent bite, I'll be happy then. Yeah, you don't want to be looking at my fizz on. Yeah, I'll come back to you if that happens. See you in a bit. Oh, Taxi Dave just caught something. I don't know what it is. I've just got my first rattle, so fingers crossed. Looks like he's coming this way, so I'll go give him a hand. thought he had about them. But that's it now. Two rods out. Got to beat the bank blank now because Taxi Dave's had a dab, and he's letting me know about it. Look at him sat there. Look. Happy as Larry now. Now he's taking a proverbial. Yeah. Let's see how long that lasts. So I'm fishing one at distance, the Ziplex is at, as far as I can chuck it, and the Icon is literally just after the first, well, yeah, the first sort of wave, 60 yards if that. So I'm sort of covering both areas. Absolutely cracking day though. Got a shower here and there, but no major. Yeah, so again, if anything happens, I'll be right back to you. Well, still waiting. It's as always, it's hard going. Nice and relaxing, don't get me wrong. Sea's flattened off even more now, but I've had one decent bite. I've not even had a rockling, believe it or not. I was guaranteed a rockling. So yeah, it's tough. I'm on a one-up clip down with yellowtails, and on the Icon I've got a pulley panel with squid and black lug wraps, so, and that's only out about 60, 70 yards. I've hammered the zippy, that's gone quite far. I'm quite happy with that. But yeah, just been talking to a guy down the beach. Really nice boat, watches the channel as well, so I'm happy with that. He was saying there was cod coming out, literally crawling up the beach yesterday. Crawling up the beach. Just mad looking at it, like I say. They'll come tomorrow and they'll be catching. Dave's rubbing his hands. Keeps letting me know he's not blanking. Bless him. He's enjoying it though. I'm enjoying it. I love it. I love being out. Love being out on the beach, it's fantastic. Would love to see a nice fish though. Would love to see a nice fish being pulled in, bar me, of course. We'll have to wait and see. I'm gonna have to change this battery in a sec as well, so I'll be back shortly if anything happens. See you in a bit. knack all again. Well, it's still there, still tough going. Just the odd tap and rattle here and there. That's it. Dave's had two flatties, he got a flounder and a dab. Not that I'd know about it. He hadn't told me. 32 times now. Well, fair play to them, fair play. He's fishing well. It's hard going, it is. It's hard going for me. It's a bit demoralising. It's one of them sessions where you just think, should I bother? But we'll keep cracking on, we'll keep trying. If that happens as normal, I'll bring you right back. Tell you, I'll never hear the end of it. Whoa. Just had a bite as well, a proper bite. Incredible. Just aren't developing into anything. It's frustrating. So the chap down the way was just fishing past where Dave was. He's gone now. Where are you? It's stunning in this. Yeah, he's gone now. He had a flatty and a whiting. Dave's had a couple of flatties, like I said. I've had knack all. I struggled, really struggled. You know, compare it to yesterday. That should be my catchphrase. That you should have been here yesterday. Yeah, that's all I ever hear when I come fishing. Should have been here yesterday. I was crawling up the beach. Can't stand it. The conditions are absolutely bang on. Thought that was going to go properly then, but seriously gutted. Tough times. Tough one for that. Take your trap off. I'm going to bring the icon in, because that's been in a while. Try and work out what I'm going to use on it. Struggling, so yeah, I'll bring it in. let's see if this works. Got a bite, first bite on the icon, and then it stops again, but it was a bite. Change your rig out. I'm sure it's just the ups that are too big. You never know though. Switch over to shorter, smaller ups. Well, that was a bite. Hi folks, just an apology here from this sort of this stage here to the end of the video. I managed to lose all the audio and a little bit of video as well, which is a bit gutting. I can only put it down to the GoPro being as old as it is, it's the old GoPro 4, so I think it's just about seeing its seeing better days, to be fair. So we're going forward, we'll remedy that. I've got a new camera, well, I've got a new camera now. I've got a new GoPro set up. So audio and any visual sort of issues should be taken care of. Yeah, which is a shame, really, because, you know, from here in, I actually managed to catch three fish, only three small dabs. But the first one was a bit bizarre because it had an edible crab attached to it with no front claws. So it wrapped his legs around my dab and decided to get a ride in. I don't know what was going on there. I've never come across it before. When I first seen the bite and struck into it, I thought I was into a really good fish. Obviously because the crab was sort of sideways on coming in. But it didn't let go. And when it come in, you'll see on the video there that there's a crab attached to a dab somehow. What was going on, I will never know. I'll never know. But no, an enjoyable end to a tough day. Again, the coast, like I said in the video, you know, it doesn't always produce. Typically, I think I'll title this video, "You Should Have Been Here Yesterday." Because that's what seems to happen a lot when I go fishing. I should have been there yesterday. Because, like I said, there was crawling up the beach. But, you know, it is what it is. Each tide's different. And many of you, or all those of you who do go sea fishing, will know that, how things change. You know, I use the same tactics you used before for catching fish, and it doesn't happen on the day. So, yeah, that's sea fishing, I suppose. But, no, a thoroughly enjoyable day. Great to be out. Great to chat with Taxi Dave. He's absolutely full of it, winning on the day, I suppose, 4-3. His face is a picture on the last cast, though, because I was still getting bites by then. So it was it was a squeaky bum time for Dave, but no, fair play to him. He did well on the day, as did the other anglers on the beach. I think there was only a couple of whiting flatties came out along as well. We was there, so tough day. But we'll do it again. Hopefully in the next video, which I don't know when it'll be. I don't know if I'll have one out for next week unless I can get out this weekend. Conditions are a little bit terrible at the moment, and they don't look good up until weekend, but I've got plans Saturday night, so I can't make it Saturday. And if I'm not hungover, I'll try and get out Sunday. So, listen, a big thanks to everybody who watches this. I really appreciate it, and I know the ending's poor. I do apologise again, but a massive thanks to you all and all the subscribers. Please continue to like, share and subscribe, as we always say. I just want to say a massive thank you as well to the Outcast Facebook group, which I'm part of, Steve Pudney and Peter Schultz. They've got a sea fishing Facebook group there, and they allow me to put my videos on. So thank you very much to them. Absolutely fantastic set of people, full of knowledge. If you ever want any advice, casting, or just general sea fishing, get on there, have a look, get your sins into it. So yeah, not much left to say really, but just a tough old day's fishing. But we'll hopefully with the sort of transformation now into summer, we'll get the summer species coming in, and hopefully we should see some decent fish back on the beach very, very soon. So good luck all, take care of each other, hope you have a great weekend, thanks for watching, really appreciate it, and I'll see you next time, bye bye.